All right. Well, good morning and welcome, everyone. I'm Catherine Lottie. I'm a small business consultant with the Northland Small Business Development Center. And today I am here with Molly Solberg, one of our marketing expert consultants, to do a Sun, Fun, and Sales Effective Summer Marketing Techniques training. We hope we can get you some great information on marketing your business during the summer season after that long, long winter we just went through. Molly, would you like to say hello?
Yes. Hello, everybody. And thank you for coming.
So before we kick off our content, I'll talk a little bit about the Northland SBDC. We provide no cost and confidential one-on-one consulting to small businesses and aspiring entrepreneurs. We serve the 7 counties and 5 tribal nations of Northeastern Minnesota. We cover a wide variety of topics, including understanding your finances and cash flow, working on business plans and buying and selling businesses. But we also have specialty consultants that can help with things like marketing, human resources, bookkeeping and QuickBooks, and web design and e-commerce. These services are provided at no cost thanks to grant funding that we receive at the local, state, and federal levels. If you're interested in receiving services, sign up on our website, northlandsbdc.org. One other note, at the end of this training, there'll be a survey that pops up on your web browser. We'd really appreciate it if you'd fill that out for us. That'll help us plan future training. With that, Molly, I'll hand it off to you to share tips on summer marketing.
Great. And a little tip here is when Catherine and I were talking about this presentation today, we were trying to think of a title for it. So we ended up each going into, I think it was ChatGPT, and we let the artificial intelligence decide the title for today. So that's how we came up with it. So another, we are not going to talk about AI today, but super helpful to just bring up ChatGPT or to go to Google and type in Bard, B-A-R-D, and Bard is a great way to ask it a question and see what the response is. And it's been pretty accurate and pretty helpful if you're trying to come up with content ideas and just say what kind of business you are and what kind of content you want to talk about. And I use a lot of Google products. So, and if you worked with me, as some of you have, you know that. And that's why I've chosen to use Bard. So that's just a little free bonus tip that we're getting right off the bat. So today we are going to talk about summer and just think about yesterday being summer or this weekend being summer, not necessarily today, but we're going to talk about the trends. And after the trends, we're going to talk about tactics. So what are some of the latest marketing trends that are relevant to 2023? How can you use these trends to target your audience? And then with the tactics, we'll talk about strategies that you can put into action. So I hope as I do, I have my paper and my pencil here and you can take some notes. It'll be exciting to see you put this into action. So let me talk about summer. Summer is a fantastic time to market to your business. People are more likely spending time outdoors, traveling, enjoying themselves, which means they're open to new experiences and new businesses. Some of you are located in tourist destinations, so we have to get ready for the tourists so that they can find your business and come and buy things. Or if you're a service-based business, that people will use your services in the summer as well. So here are some summer marketing trends to watch for 2023. And that is mobile marketing. And this may not seem like a new thing, but in 2023, our friends at Google, and here's my phone, which is 85 to 90% of the search engine share in our area. So about 85% of your customers are using Google search. And Google search is now switching over to how fast your website and your content loads on mobile. Even though I'm business to business, most people view me on a desktop. They're still going to judge me and my website on how quickly it loads on mobile. So if my website is slow, it's going to push my website down further down in the browser, and it's going to move up my competitors whose website might load more quickly. So, and how you can do it is ask your friends and family and you do it yourself. Just pull up your website. And I am so guilty of always looking at my website on a desktop, I sometimes forget. So I have it saved as on my Google search so that I can go back into that page and push refresh and see how quickly it keeps loading as I add more content. And you are going to be adding more content once you get done with this presentation. So making sure that your images are now compressed, and there's a lot of applications out there. Like if you have a WordPress website, there's Smoosh, which can compress your images so they load more quickly. So definitely be monitoring that. And more people are using their phones when they're traveling up to your destination. So I know we have some folks on here from Ely today. Hello. And as people are driving up to Ely, they're going to be on their phones looking for things to do. So you need to make sure that your business is using a responsive website, which most websites are these days. Responsive meaning if you open it on mobile, the view changes, or on an iPad. So mobile marketing. Second thing we're going to talk about is obviously, we have a question that just popped up. So let me just see if it's relevant. Okay. So is there an ideal load time for a mobile site that you should be looking for? You can always go into Google and type in Google Developers Speed Test. And it's called, I think it's like Insights. And you put in your website and it tells you how fast it loads on mobile. So it's down to just a few seconds. So under 3 seconds, it should load. And I think once your customers come in and they push the button, if it doesn't load automatically, they're just going to hit the back button and go to your competitor's website. Great question. Next, we're going to talk about social media is a great way to connect and promote your business. I think we know that. And I think people associate me, I run the social media breakfast in town, like, hey, let's talk about social media. And I'll always tell people, let me look at your website. And they're like, no, I don't need help with my website. I'm like, social media, all of the marketing that we do is there to drive traffic to your website. Your website sells your products. Your website lists your services. It has all of your information. So social media is a great way in the summer to talk about summer fun content so people see it and go to your website and therefore buy your products or come and visit you at your shop or use your services. So with social media and summer, that brings up my best friend Canva, C-A-N-V-A. And I can't see you all, but raise your hands if you use Canva. I think a lot of us out there use it and it's fabulous. You can definitely get the pro model or you can use the free model. And I just go to my Canva and I type in summer. I click on Facebook posts. It has templates for everything, presentations, Facebook posts, Facebook cover photos, Instagram stories, Instagram posts, flyers, event marketing, anything that you need. And I just typed in summer and voila, all of these appeared. I can click on one and look at how bright and fun these are. We can click on one and it's summertime. Do you have yours? I would use it to say, do you have your summer marketing in order? And then I would download it and post this onto my Facebook and Instagram accounts or my LinkedIn profile or all of the above and my Google business profile. So we're going to create this fun and bright summer marketing tip. And it's an extremely helpful tool, again, to use for free. Just click on the text, edit it to your content and download it.
It's amazing. I just started myself with it in the last month and easy to use and beautiful options.
It's, yeah, fantastic. And look at it. It's so fun. So whoever is posting, if this is your content, it's eye-catching, it's bright, I'm going to immediately go to it and seeing what you're offering. The next trend is video marketing, and it's been a consistent trend and it's not going anywhere. And I'm not very comfortable doing it, but I have to get more comfortable doing it, is creating that video. It's a powerful tool. It tells your story. It engages your customers. It's an easy thing to do. You can create a little. If you do a video, if you go live on your Facebook feed, it all of a sudden alerts all of your customers. Molly Solberg Marketing is live. Like, oh, what does she have to say? They can click can tune in. If I'm giving some valuable tips, they can stick around. It is viewed longer than if you're going live. It's viewed longer than if you were to create a video and upload it separately. And definitely don't have to go live if you're not comfortable. Try it, especially if you're doing something summer and fun. If you're going to be outside, if you're going to have an event, just go live for even just a few seconds. And if you're not comfortable having the camera on you talking, then just turn the camera around and show the event or show some products or talk about the services that you provide. But just video marketing isn't going anywhere. It's absorbed longer, retained longer. So your content should include, if we're going to do a nice little bright, colorful Canva post, the next post you should do should be a video post. So do not forget about video. It's really uncomfortable, but try it. Write that down on our little note-taking today. I will make a video in the next month and post it on there the next week. Video marketing statistics. 90% say that product videos help them make a decision. If you sell a product, those products should have videos associated with them. 92% of mobile video consumers share videos with others. Online, 80% of online viewers recall a video ad viewed in the last 30 days. So that's pretty crazy. 50% of internet users look for videos related to a product or a service before visiting a store. Half of your potential customers would look at a video before determining to buy your product or use your service. Pretty amazing statistics. Email marketing, email marketing, email marketing. If you've worked with me recently, you know that I've talked about this a lot. And it's extremely effective because look at all of our inboxes. I don't unsubscribe. And some of the larger companies, I get 2 to 3 emails a day. Not all of them are relevant. You don't have to email people every day, but every month would be nice. It's a great way to stay in touch with your customers, promote your business, make sure that you're sending relevant and timely emails. What do you have going on this summer in your business? What's going on? I want to know. I'm not going to see all of your social media posts. I am going to see an email that you sent out. So send out an email from the summer. This is what's going on for the summer. We have a summer open house. We have the services that we're providing that are unique to summer. Obviously, I'm talking about summer marketing that's unique to my business. If you are a handyman or a contractor, this is deck season, pergolas, screen porches, if landscaping, flowers, summer dresses, clothes, wedding events, vacations, all of that stuff, your business can find a way to be relevant to that. So talk about that in your email marketing. Any specials that you have going on, promotions, make a special, make a promotion. And these next few slides are going to drill in the fact that email marketing is extremely effective, 100 times higher than social media click-through rate. If they see a post, will they click on the Facebook post and go to your website? 100 times higher, they will click on your email and go to your website. So each email that you can collect is a little valuable little piece of gold. 15% of daily e-coupon emails are opened with an unsubscribe rate of just 0.1. So if you're offering, and I tell my clients, throw in an event that you're having, throw in a product or service you want to feature, and then throw in a tip that's relevant to you. I can throw in a free marketing tip, as well as talking about maybe it's time that I meet with you again and we do another assessment on your business to see where your marketing lacks. So making sure that you offer a little tip. Is it a gardening tip? Is it, again, your business has something in it that's relevant to summer. So throw in a tip and people will not unsubscribe. And they're your followers and they know you and they see you. So they're not going to unsubscribe, especially since you're not doing it every day. 50% of your customers prefer to communicate with you through email. Just 7% on social media. Just letting these just sink in so you know the importance of email marketing. 77% of your customers prefer to receive anything promotions that you have going on through email, 4% on Facebook. That's another fascinating statistic. Email marketing was the most effective marketing channel by 64% of companies. So, and MailChimp, especially for smaller businesses, I think it's under 500, you can go for free. So you can go into MailChimp. I help my clients set up a header with your logo and your color branding, and then a footer that has your business information, address, phone number, email, your social media channels. And then we set up 3 blocks, talk about an event, talk about a product, talk about a service or a free tip. We send it out to our customers. We can just upload those. And then we just go back in a month later and hit replicate or duplicate, brings up the same thing, take out those 3 blocks, add 3 new blocks and send it out. So past few slides have showed us how extremely valuable that is. And I've seen my clients with open rates that are far, far exceed that 15%. My local clients have open rates of between 25 and 40%. So that's pretty crazy. And that means that they're opening it and going to your website. That doesn't mean that they're, which they all are pretty much, seeing your title, seeing some of your content, and maybe they're deleting it, but they still saw everything that you have to offer. And maybe they'll come and visit your website or you on social media later. Email is 40 times better at acquiring new customers than Facebook. So make sure that your website has a spot for people to sign up. It doesn't have to be a pop-up if you think that's annoying, but maybe after your first header, you can say, hey, if you sign up for our email newsletter, you will be the first to know about new products, about new services, about any specials we have going on, any tips. Make it worth their while to give you their email address. Moving on, another trend. Oh no, this is an example that was in my inbox was Apple Plus. Spring into summer with a fitness roadmap. So here is we can take cues from Apple that has a multi-million dollar marketing budget, because I'm assuming with a show of hands that I can't see that nobody has a multi-million dollar marketing budget. So let's just see the people that have. So obviously Apple is talking right now, spring into summer with a fitness roadmap. And don't read too much into this, that this was in my inbox, okay? Because I'm walking my dog at a brisk pace every day. So I'm keeping in shape, but this wound up in my newsfeed or in my inbox. So they probably know I could do a little more exercising. I get it. So they're on brand and they're doing some good target marketing here, but they're talking about getting healthy and downloading the app and free trial with bright colors. So now we know I can go to Canva and I can do a plain colored background, add a couple bright colors, and talk about the products or services that I have for summer. And then it says, get one free month to make the most of summer. So this is the title that they have. So that's an email that I had just received. The next trend is content marketing. And this content marketing, again, if you've worked with me, is talking about content that's relevant to your business. And I use the example of Airbnb showing properties that you can rent all around the world. We get that. Then they started creating to find new customers content relevant to their brand. So what does that mean? If you're staying in an Airbnb, you're not in your house. So you're not at home. You're somewhere new. So they started creating these local lists. Are you staying in San Francisco? Here is the best park. Here's the best place to take photos. Here's the best burrito. Here's the best microbrew, here's the best cocktail, here's the best bakery. So it created this content relevant to their brand to attract a new audience. So listen to your buyers, decide on topics and themes, create the content, post the content, and then evaluate. And I think my clients we forget the piece about evaluating, going back and seeing what worked last year. Go into your, and we'll maybe talk about this in a later slide, but go into Facebook and Instagram and check your insights and see what was doing well last year. Oh my gosh, people really loved it when I did the post about spraying my dog down with the hose because it was hot. Any animal post obviously is going to do well. So I'm going to do another one of those because it brought more eyes to my content and my social media. And then hopefully they clicked and went to my website. So create content, again, that's relevant to your brand. Are you here in Duluth? Talk about grandma's marathon coming up. That brings in thousands, tens of thousands of people to our area. So join that conversation. Are you up on the range? Are you near, you know, mountain biking up there now? Or the lakes? So there's a fishing, there's a lot to do. So talk about all that content that's relevant to your brand. Share it on your website, social media, and email marketing campaigns. And that's kind of what I talked about those tips that are relevant to your business. So local marketing. And if you work with me, that's huge with your local listings, like your Google Business account or your Bing Places or your Yahoo or Yelp. That's how people are going to find out about you. Here's a little cool, colorful summary graphic. 46% of all Google searches are looking for local information. Half of searches are searching for local information. Huge. 72% of consumers did a local search, visited a store within 5 miles. 72%. So make sure when you Google yourself, if you are a plumber, make sure you Google or have your friends and family, so your IP address doesn't match your business, but have them Google and say, like, can you search for plumbers in Duluth and see where I come up? Oh, I come up third. I need to work on my Google Business account. I need to get more reviews. I need to post more photos so that I move up to that top spot. 88% of searches to a local business, they'll visit you or call you. 70% of customers will visit a physical store. So it just shows you that people are more likely to support local businesses. So focus on local marketing this summer. You can run a print ad in a newspaper. And I find that valuable for a lot of my clients on the range who have a lot of their customers that read the newspaper every week. So making sure that that isn't traditional marketing isn't dead. It isn't all just social and online. So, or magazines, you know, people going up the North Shore are grabbing a lot of the local magazines that are printed up there and putting an ad in there. So local marketing matters. That means making sure that your Google Business account, Bing Places, if you have a physical address. I don't have a physical address, so I can only use Google Business. I can't use Bing Places or Yelp. I need a physical address for that. But I try to get as many reviews and post new photos as much as I can. So local marketing, don't forget about that. These statistics tell you why. Those are the trends for 2023. Now we're going to start moving into the next phase, which is the marketing tactics. Tactics we can use based on trends, actual tips that we can use in our business. Not today because it's 43 in Duluth, but tomorrow when it's going to be nicer, or this weekend. So specific marketing tactics you can use: host a summer event. It doesn't have to be as huge as a block party. Maybe just a customer appreciation day. Events are a great way to get people excited about your business. Another thing is when you create an event for your business on Facebook, you have an extremely large reach as opposed to just posting something on Facebook. Not everybody can see it. If you create an event, that's something that I do on getting close to the weekend. I'll pull up Facebook events and just scroll through. I'll hit the local button and just see what's going on in my area. Oh, there's a shop that's having a sale. I'll have to stop by there because there's another event going in across town, so I can hit one and then go to the other. Hosting a summer event, finding a way to do it is a fantastic way to do that. And I'll talk about an example kind of coming up in a few. So summer contest, enter to win a gift card. Where did you just see this bright and colorful graphic? Could it be from Canva? Yes, it is. So I just went in there and typed this in, downloaded it, and there you go. Run a summer contest. It's a great way for excitement. Make sure your contest or giveaway is easy to enter and that the prizes are valuable. When I was at Duluth PAC, we try to have a summer photo contest, and the winner would get between a $100 or a $500 gift card. It made it a value for them to enter. So that was super fun, and everybody was engaged and talking about it and commenting on the different photos. So think of something that's relevant to your business, whether, again, you sell a product or have a service. So running a fun summer contest with this bright graphic is a fun way to grab attention. And if you have people, like, I get a lot of local businesses that want you to tag somebody in it, tag a friend that you would take on a summer vacation. So I get tagged a lot, and then I go in and see, like, oh, my friend is entering this contest and this looks fabulous.
Are you still there, Molly?
So make sure that your content is relevant to the summer season and it will appeal to your larger audience. So, and your target audience. So remember, our friends at Maurice's, right down the street here, they're talking about red, white, and beautiful. What's your favorite? So there's three things that we could buy for 4th of July. So they're already posting their content now, so we can buy the outfits and be ready for the summer. And I love that it's with Maurice's headquartered in Minnesota, because they have 4th of July as either being a sweater, t-shirt, or a tank top, which could be any of the weather seasons today, or great summer sweepstakes, 7 days of prizes. Subscribe to text. So they're getting your mobile number to text you sales that they have coming up after that. So text it and you can win and get a free t-shirt, and there's 7 days of prizes. So day four, 10 winners. So 10 winners are gonna win a t-shirt. So brilliant to Maurice's, and very timely because they're just posting this, I think yesterday. So this is everything that they're posting now. Again, these are products, but service-based. You can have a contest to win an hour free of whatever your service is. So go to Canva, download that summer themed content, and really think about what your customers are doing this summer. My customers, are a lot of them are located in tourist areas. So I have to make sure that they are talking to those tourists. If you have a business in a tourist area, are you talking about going on vacation? Did you forget something at home? Are they going to an event where you can capture them? If there's a lot of people coming to Duluth for Grandma's Marathon, a fraction of them are running, all of the rest are supporters. What else are those supporters going to do? Can you offer, do you have a restaurant or a microbrewery? Whatever you have, talk to the people with what they're doing. You know who your target audience is. Find that little sweet spot and talk to them. Well, I know that my sweet spot is, you know, working parents. So I'm going to talk about working parents, and now their kids have gotten off the school bus for the last day, and now they're inhabiting your home. And you're like, what am I going to do with these things all summer long? I'm an empty nester now, but I remember those days. I'm like, oh my gosh, what are we gonna do this summer? So think about ideas about that. So just think about what your customers are going through and talk to them with relevant summer content. Here are some of our local friends talking about summer content. Here's Ursa Minor. It's Frisbee golf season. They've created branded discs. So now everybody with a disc that they've paid for is walking around as a free advertisement at all the local parks this summer. So super smart on their part to create a branded summer product and summer colors, and to talk about something that doesn't have anything to do with beer, but here you go. So good job on Ursa Minor's part. And then we have Duluth Grill. So Duluth Grill does something right here. The first thing they do is they're talking about something tropical. So they've created summer content, which is tropical. Key lime pie, pineapple, coconut, strawberries. But what they've also done here is they've tagged Third Street Bakery. They've partnered with a local business that makes granola and they've tagged them in it. And now Third Street Bakery is going to say, did you know our granola is now available at Duluth Grill, and tag them in it? Because Duluth Grill has a little bit larger following than Third Street Bakery. So the two businesses are working together. Brilliant. So a lot of fun things being done right here by our local businesses. And you can see Duluth Grill's got a bunch of hashtags in here. Tropical vibes, breakfast, Minnesota foodies, Duluth, Minnesota, patio season. Here's another friend in Lincoln Park. It's our friend over at Lila Boutique. So she is great with partnering with other businesses. She is located in the same space as the 180 coffee. And I think Little Nietzsche's is there, and Red Market, North and Shore is there. And I think the Goat Hill Marketplace. So they do a fantastic job of promoting each other. So here she says they're Ingerloff's. I suppose it's in the basement of that. So come visit us. The shops at Ingerloff are hosting a spring market. So brilliant. They just all of a sudden got together and like, let's create a spring market. And then let's do it again and create a summer market. So they're just creating these things as a way to advertise for each other. And then you can see here, she has her hashtags. Another thing that Lila Boutique does is partners with another local business. Mix Cosmetiques is located in Woodland, and she makes her own skincare products and lotions. She offers classes where you can go and make your own lotions or lip glosses. It's really awesome. And so they have partnered together to make products for the other one, and then they tag each other in them. So partnering with other business amplifies. And I think we know that from Lincoln Park being what it is today, because Duluth Grill, Frost River, Bent Paddle could not afford a billboard. The three of them together could. So they all pooled their money, created one billboard, and now we have the Lincoln Park area, which is really successful. So partnering with other businesses works. Use summer-related hashtags. I think we just saw that on some of the last posts. The top 10 summer hashtags for 2023 are summer, love, Instagood, photo of the day, pic of the day, beautiful, nature, happy, fashion, summer is here, summer weather, summer loving, spring, summer, end of summer, summer dress. So these are more popular hashtags that you can use in your businesses. A hashtag is just a way for people who are searching for summer, and all of a sudden you will be in those search results. So people can see summer dress, hashtag summer dress. And they can see all the results for that. So again, we are going to take some cues from those businesses that have million-dollar marketing budgets. Update your website and your social media pages with summer-themed content. You can't launch your website and have it sit there and not touch it. The search engines will never visit you if you never add new content. So if anything, create, and you can go into Canva again and create a summer banner talking about the services you provide, the products you sell, and upload that onto your website. Make sure that you label that image that you download from Canva or that you create or that you have a local graphic designer create for you. Make sure you label that image as summer marketing, Molly Solberg marketing, Duluth. So now that image can be read by search engines rather than just uploading a JPEG photo. The JPEG photos with numbers, search engines can't read. So you need all of your images that you put online to have your business name and keywords so search engines can find it. So let's just go to the people that have the biggest marketing budget. Walmart, what do they have? Memorial Day prep, summer savings. Then they have a scooter here. Scooter, people are riding scooters. Say goodbye to pests. We went mountain biking this weekend in Grand Rapids and got carried away by the mosquitoes. So this is extremely relevant content that Walmart has here. So again, what are people, if you sell electronics, see what Best Buy is doing for marketing. If you sell clothing, see what Maurice's or Walmart is doing. If you are, you know, a marketing or a plumber, look at what some of the national plumbing companies are doing for content. So you don't need to reinvent the wheel. They've already done that testing for you. Here's another example is our friends at Target. Summer kickoff sale, sunny day deals. 30% off those things that people are talking about. So again, bright colors and a sale. Front and center. And then again, I mentioned this earlier, but don't forget to track your results. It's important to see what works and what doesn't work. So decide what you're going to measure. Are you going to measure, I'm going to create an event and I'm going to see how many people attend the event, how many people click on the event, how many people share the event, how many people say they're interested, how many people say they're going. I'm going to create a post on Facebook and Instagram and see who interacts with it more. I have a lot of clients who have 1,000 followers on Instagram and 200 on Facebook. I have clients that have 2,000 on Facebook and 200 on Instagram. So it's really interesting to see the dynamics. And most of them are either higher on Instagram or they're equal on both is usually the average. But what are you going to measure? You're just going to measure how many likes it has, how many shares it has, whatever those interactions are, how many more people visited with your Google business listing. You can go to your insights and see how many people saw your profile in June as opposed to saw your profile in February. How much more traffic are you getting? So if you're getting a lot more traffic on your Google business listing, make sure that you're adding a summer, make sure that you're adding an update on Google business with this pretty summer photo, and then you're talking about your products and services that are related to the summer piece, and it can just live there for a couple months. So remember to track your results. And I think we're all pretty guilty of just posting and forgetting about it and not going back and looking and seeing what does well. Offer seasonal discounts and promotions. They're always looking for a good deal. So a seasonal discount or promotion is a great way to attract new customers and encouraging existing customers to spend more. You can offer discounts and or loyalty programs or rewards or anything. I went to summer sales and I went to Etsy, and Etsy was really cool that they create all these summer sizzler event. So it was really cool that they went in and created this whole marketing campaign for you through Etsy at a pretty reasonable cost. So again, I encourage you all to use local friends, graphic designers. They are fabulous. And we want to make sure that we employ our graphic designers. If you just need something quick done, then go ahead and check out Etsy and they can create a whole marketing campaign for you. Or again, go to our best friend Canva. And this is kind of interesting. The trend and tactic was guerrilla marketing. And I was like, guerrilla marketing sounds like scary, like guerrilla. But it just means thinking outside the box. And when I was at Duluth Pack, we try to get together every Monday and have a marvelous marketing Monday meeting and think of ideas that were outside the box. Those are the ones that get noticed. So here's a local restaurant saying, eat here or we'll both starve. Here is a ballet class that has a little flyer with the little numbers listed that look like the little tutu on a ballet skirt. So a lot of them were kind of fun and inventive. If you have a physical location, a fun and inventive little sandwich board and really writing some clever things on there, drawing something clever on there. It is, and I tell my clients that too, if you have a physical location, do you have a sign out front so people can see you? You're on a road, so that's a free billboard that you can have. How do your windows look? Do you have really bright summery things in your windows? Hang some bright summery kind of tissue things that are really bright. Make sure that you get some decals that you can stick on the window so people driving by or sitting at a stop sign can easily glance and see the products and not just your business name, because that doesn't really say much, but the products and services that you provide on the outside of the window. So really summer those up. But the guerrilla marketing is kind of an interesting tactic. What could you do that would be really new and different and interesting? Kind of fun to think about. So before you guerrilla market, it's the fun, whimsical cousin of traditional marketing, but it still requires a strategy and a plan. So start with a goal of what the guerrilla marketing is there to do. Get more people in the door, get more people to buy, get more people to sign up to my email list, get more people to follow me on Instagram, whatever that is, think of something unique and clever, and maybe look at some other industry kind of influencers in your field and see if they're doing something fun and interesting that you can kind of use as some inspiration for you. And then some additional tips for marketing: bright colors, summer imagery. They're more likely drawn to bright colors. They'll use them in your marketing. So, and again, here's my, this is Google Market, summer marketing. So you can see all these little cool summer marketing ideas that I just Googled. Focus again on local marketing. People are more likely to support local businesses, so focus on local marketing efforts this summer. Again, print ads, local magazines. So this is all of the fabulous women from Bent Paddle, the two owners of Bent Paddle, who just had their festiversary party this weekend. So Locally Laid Eggs was there promoting, and they brought some of their chickens, some of their Lola chickens. So obviously this is great cross promotion. There was a huge event. Locally Laid asked if they could come and be at the event and thought of something fun to do. I think it was maybe chicken poop bingo or something. So they found a guerrilla style marketing way. And then they picked up the chickens, they took these photos, and now it's the Bent Paddle people and the Locally Laid people, and they're spreading the content. So now how many more people saw this Locally Laid post as opposed to if they would have just said, buy our eggs? So this is a fun way that they interacted with each other. So, and that just happened this past weekend. I was not there, but my friends went and it was fabulous. Get involved in the community. Get involved by volunteering, donating. It's a great way to build goodwill. Again, our friends at Ursa Minor. So Ursa Minor partnered with Safe Haven Shelter and had a fun run, and the proceeds went to Safe Haven. And it was a way for everybody to go down to Ursa and hang out at Ursa and build goodwill there, but also as a chance for them to be spread some goodwill for the community and providing a big check to the Women's Safe Haven Shelter and Resource Center. So it's an easy way to do, think of a business or a nonprofit. There's a lot of nonprofits that are struggling, especially because of COVID. So find a way to partner with them. And if you can help out their cause and in turn elevate you and your business. And have fun. Summer is a time to relax and enjoy yourself. So make sure that you're having fun with your marketing efforts. I don't know if I would be jumping off backwards off a cliff, but hopefully he's relaxed and having a good time. And they just took a cool image. Again, this was in my Facebook feed and it caught my eye that like, ooh, it's a sale. And it was bright marketing and it was talking about Memorial Day, which we're all thinking about. So the more fun you have, the more likely your customers to have fun with your business. So think outside the box and do something fun. So additional tips again, I keep saying it. People are traveling during summer, so focus on the local customer. So you want to reach those customers that are traveling, but you don't want to forget about your local base. So it's important to focus on the people that you have that are going to get the local customers are going to get you through the winter months. So don't forget about them too. So you can run local ads. You can, again, host a local event or partner with a local business. And we're going to recap on using social media. It's a great way to reach a larger audience during the summer. So post that interesting and engaging content that will capture your target customer. and your customer that you already have. You want to keep both of those. You want to make sure you're doing half of your marketing to keep your current customers happy and about half of your time trying to attract new customers. Again, run summer promotions, free samples, discounts, anything. This is a time when people are excited and they're traveling and they're going on vacations and they're spending money. So make sure that you're in that conversation. And get creative. Don't be afraid to get creative with your marketing campaigns. This summer is a great time to try new things, see what works, make sure that you are going back and checking on that. And I want you all to just, we all go to presentations and we all sit here and yeah, I'm listening to her talk, but I want you to actually go to Canva, find a cool template, download it, add some content, think of an event, think of a promotion that you can have and get this done. I will be getting a list of who was all here. I will be going to all of your social media sites. I will be grading you and judging you. No, I won't. Maybe. But anyway, I'm excited to see all that summer content that you create. So thank you for having me, Northland Small Business Center. I hope you businesses that aren't current clients of the Small Business Center, they're a fabulous resource here. So here is all of those things that you should follow, and hopefully they will be creating some great new fun summer content. And thank you for having us. Thank you, Catherine, so much. We had fun coming up with this and fun using artificial intelligence to come up with the title of it.
We sure did.
Hopefully we all get some more sales. And now it would be fantastic if we have some questions. We've got some time. And there's Sarah. Sarah had a comment and not a question. So thank you. We just have some thank yous. Do we have anything? I want to see everybody's content. Anything else that please put it in the question and answer. Otherwise, I think we'll just wrap this up and feel free to reach out to Catherine, reach out to the Northland Small Business Center. I am one of the two marketing experts. There's also Melissa Cox, who is fabulous up on the range. She has amazing graphic design skills.
Thank you, Molly. I'm going to echo Kelly's comment. Your excitement is contagious. That was really inspiring. So thanks for the time you took to put that together and to share that with us. As a reminder, if you want to work with Molly or any other consultant one-on-one at no charge, just sign up at northlandsbdc.org. You can look forward to an email that will include a link to today's presentation. And again, please watch for that pop-up in your browser to take the survey. We'll use that information to plan future trainings. So thanks everyone for joining us. Have a great summer. Bye.
All right.